Welcome. This video we will see how to use color scales in conditional formatting. I am using dark mode to reduce eye strain. How to use it? Look at the description. We have already seen different types of conditional formatting. You should first see the data bars and icon sets videos which I have created earlier. Today we will see color scales. Let's start with simple data. It's just 1 to 10. You can choose either a 2 color scale or a 3 color scale. We will start with a simple 2 color scale. Yellow to green. How does this work? The minimum number gets one color. The maximum number gets another color. And intermediate numbers get a mixture of yellow and green in this case. If it's nearer to the minimum color, it gets more yellow. If it's nearer to the maximum color, it gets more green. Now let's apply this to different sets of numbers. I want to do format paint multiple times, so I'm going to double click on the format painter. Now you will get a better idea of how this color distribution works. If there was a 3 color scale, let me show you how this works. So instead of 2 boundary colors, we have 3 colors, minimum, maximum, and middle. So if you use it for mixed data, it may or may not be very useful. Even when I apply it to large set of numbers, it's still looking jumbled up. So the real value of color scale comes when you zoom out. Here you will clearly see that there is no single pattern. Now let's try it with something else. The data looks similar. It's very difficult to understand how the data is distributed. But when I apply color scale, you will notice that there is a cluster of high values here, cluster of low values here, and you can even see exceptions very clearly here. Another use of color scale is to find abnormally large or small values. Using the same color scale, but because some values were much bigger, 350, 500, 400, they become green, everything else is yellowish. That is called outliers. And finally, when you want to show a pattern and not worry about numbers, because anyway those numbers are not readable. In that case, apply conditional formatting. You go to manage rules, edit the rule. Unlike other types like data bar, which says show bar only, and icon sets, which says show icon only, when it comes to color scale, show color only option doesn't exist. Not to worry, we will do it in a different way. So if you go to format cells, this is a shortcut to have a number but not display it. Put 3 semicolon in the custom formatting. How does this work? Well, that's for another video. But now here you can see how people are performing across time without getting confused with individual numbers. Now this can be copy pasted in a PowerPoint presentation for display purpose. That is how you use color scales. If you like this video, do share it with your friends, colleagues, and loved ones. Of course, I'm sure you'll subscribe and press the bell icon. That's all for now. See you very soon with another video. Thank you.